皆さんおはようございます。
おはようございます。
我们谢谢杰弗瑞弟兄来提醒我们。
We are thankful to the Jeffrey for reminders.
我们要去跟神得奖赏。
That he desire for his gift.
那怎么样才能从神那里得到奖赏？
How do we receive more from the Lord?
再问一次，怎么样才能够从神那里得奖赏？
How do we receive reward from the Lord?
有答案的分享一下好不好？
Are you going to share your answer?
小红弟兄，
按照神的话语去行，
就给他的奖赏。So, according to the word of God.
还有没有？
有，你们有。
既然财宝没有天分。
So, our treasures in heaven.
Okay, 很好，来，我要。我想圣经的原则是要我们成为一个忠心的仆人。
And the principle from the Bible is that we should be faithful servant to him for the reward.
神在这个短暂的世界给你很多东西。
In this short lifetime, I'll receive from him many things.
有人有不同的才能。
Different gifts for different people.
有人就给了你一堆小孩哈。
Some people are receiving from the Lord many children.
这是用神交托给你的哈。
And they are, entrusted to you.
也许神给你有很赚钱的能力哈。
And maybe God gave you the ability to earn.
那也许神给你有能力去带领人来信耶稣。
And maybe giving you the ability to lead others to Christ.
所以，当你有这种神从给你的能力、才能呢，你就用出来哈，忠心的用出来，就得神的奖赏。
When you receive all these gifts, you can just use them, and God will reward you someday.
那我想就是我们要努力的。奔走人生的道路嘛。
And I think we should really work hard to walk the path of our lives.
那当然会面对很多困难。
We will surely encounter many difficulties.
很多人不理解你哈。
So many will misunderstand you.
并且来批评你哈。
And even criticize.
但是你还是要坚持神给你的托付，努力的来走。
You have to stick to the work that God has entrusted us.
那我真的比较幸运了，我的一生到目前为止，虽然有短暂的失败哈。
I feel I'm very blessed. Although in my lifetime I did have short a time of failures.
但是我的家庭，我的太太都很支持我。
My family and my other half supported me though.
甚至我的女儿都是很赞同我的做法。
And my daughters, they were with me in my decisions.
所以我继续要走这个人生的晚年哈。
And so I will continue to walk this path in my life.
那希望大家彼此代祷哈。
Let's all pray for each other.
Okay, 那还记得上个礼拜讲什么吗
？Last week, regarding our topic, do you remember?
假如你上个礼拜没有来，你还知道我讲什么，那才奇怪哈。
If you know what I did talk about, even if you were not here, that must be surprising.
那上个礼拜是从马太前面这一段谈到，耶稣已经成全了义务，耶稣已经完成了这个救恩哈。
And we talked about last week, Jesus fulfilling the law and completing the work of salvation.
耶稣用他的教导，用他的生命哈，来 让我们得到完全。
Through Jesus, his teaching and his own life, completed the salvation for us.
叫你好的读圣经，知道耶稣他的一生有一个方向啊。
If you read the Bible, you see that Jesus had one direction in his life.
他不是随便走，他是有一个方向，他天父教他的，他是走。
And he walked according to what God has led him.
那就是走到这个十字架嘛。
And walk towards the cross.
然后他在十字架讲了一句话，就成了。
And on the cross, he said, finally, it's done.
那我一直在提，我们人都是很自私，都给人家不好的哈。
And I would often mention that we are self-centered. We give others which things that are not good.
但是上帝给我们的是他最宝贝的儿子耶稣基督给我们。
But our God gave us the most precious for Him, that's His only Son.
那我们可以借着耶稣得到一个新的生命。
And through Christ we can receive a new life.
这也就是耶稣一直在讲，你们要重生了，你们要明白神的心意了。
This is what Jesus was saying, that we should be born again and understand His will.
那我重生之后，我才明白我的生命是在乎神那里。
And after I was born again, I learned and understand that my life was from God.
所以神呢一直在引导我走很多人生的方向哈。
God continued to lead me in my direction in life.
有两次到美国哈。
Twice I went to the United States.
那现在是搁浅在日本。
Now I'm down in Japan.
I was stuck in Japan here right now.
And stuck in Japan.
但是神也给我们很大的祝福。
But God saved us. I mean, God blessed us abundantly.
所以你不要怕，当你信靠神的引导，你就会得到神的祝福。
So don't be afraid. If you have faith in Him, He will.
那接着马太用了六个例子啊来讲解为什么耶稣会成全的律法这件事情。
In the book of Matthew, Jesus used six examples for how he completed or fulfilled the law.
我想律法有时候解释哈，因人的解释不一样，所以它应用出来的也不一样啊。
Regarding the law, there are different ways of explaining or interpreting it, and it depends on the person.
我想我们在马路上开车最常看到的就是那个红绿灯哈。
And when we are driving, we very important is to see that we see the traffic lights.
当你到红绿灯的时候，大部分人都一定要停在那等哈。
And of course, with the red light, we know we should.Wait.
你有没有听过一个解释？有人讲说，我正在等，那没有车子，那我就冲过去了，有没有
？And you have probably heard people saying, "I waited for the red light, but nobody came, so I moved forward."
但是大部分的日本人都一定就在那等，他不管有没有车，他就在那等，说慢慢。
But Japanese will not do that mostly. They will wait no matter what for the red light.
所以。同样是红绿灯，对每个人的反应都不一样啊。
And different people have different perceptions about this thing.
所以耶稣对律法的解释，我们会接着来讲，他是超过那些律法教师的解释哈。
So Jesus is now trying to explain the law, and his explanation is more than what the others.
那今天我们要谈的是到底。基督徒能不能深信呢
？Today we are going to study about Christians. Is it all right for them to be angry?
假如一个人跟你约会了，约时间了，要来见你，那结果没有来，你能不能生气
？If somebody had an appointment with you and did not appear at that time, would you be angry?
一般他们会调查，你可以等他多久？一小时、两小时、三小时
And for some researchers, they will try to see how many hours can you wait or how many hours do people wait for appointments to be done?
只要你期限短了，你等五分钟你都等不了，就唰就跑掉了。
If you are the short tempered type, you would leave by 5 minutes.
小米有还有耐心，你要等了2个小时啊。
You are patient. You are patient. You will be probably waiting for even for 2 hours.
所以，对这个约会我们要守信了。既然要去了，就赶快去了，不要在那耽搁，甚至不来啊。
So regarding appointments, let the other person wait, and it's be on time.
所以你要生气是一门很大的学问啊。
So being whether you should get angry or not, this is a great lesson.
所以你今天从圣经会学一个原则啊。
And from the Bible, we can learn some principles.
那你也看到你周遭一些人、哦、他生气好像是在吃家常便饭、哦、
And if you look around, some people get angry as if it is an everyday thing, like having meal.
但是有些你要激怒他，让他生气都不容易啊。
However, some people, no matter how you try to steer the person to anger, sometimes you won't be successful.
那到底我们能不能生气啊
？So, is it?Can we really be angry?
所以当你在读圣经的人，你看到，哎，神怎么跟我们一样的？他也会生气啊。
And if you read the Bible, you will say, "Oh, how come God Himself get angry?"
那其实神在旧约中很多他的那暴怒哦，都是一个事实啊。
And in the Bible, in the Old Testament.Many realities were described there regarding the anger from the Lord.
但是他的生气跟我们的生气是完全不一样啊。
But God's anger is different, completely different from ours.
因为我们知道神是很有慈爱，也是很公义的啊。
Know that God is full of love, loving kindness, but He is also just.
他很体恤人的软弱哦，他也是。完完全全的圣洁。
He is very merciful regarding our weaknesses, but he is also completely just and righteous.
神不会改变啊，他不轻易发怒。
God never changes, and he doesn't doesn't get angry just like that.
他的发怒，他的审判，都是因为人的罪。
And his anger is because of sin.
那我们来看一个例子，我们来看约翰福音哦，2:13-17。
In John chapter 2:13-17, here's an example. John chapter 2:13-17.
约翰第二章。
John chapter 2.
找到没？13-17。
13-17.
OK, 13-17。编辑兄找到没？然后帮我们大声念哈。13-17哈。
犹太人的逾越节近了，耶稣就上耶路撒冷去，看见店里有卖牛、羊、鸽子的，并有兑换银钱的人坐在那里。耶稣就拿绳子做鞭子，把牛羊都赶出店去，搞出兑换银钱之人的金银钱，推翻他们的桌子，又对卖鸽子的说：“把这些东西拿去，不要将我父的店做当做买卖的地方。”他的门徒就想起经上记着说：“我为你的店心里着急，如同火烧。”
好，谢谢，哇。
Thank you.
耶稣演的这出戏嘛，实在太轰动了哈。
This is a very dramatic scene for Jesus.
我不晓得我在现场，我到底会不会吓到了？哇
！If I were present in the situation, would I be shocked?
平常都温和在劝人、帮助人的，突然哇
！He is he used to be a very gentle teacher, but suddenly he burst into anger.
这也是他们将圣殿的本质都改变了。
It's because they changed the temple into a different thing.
他们在那里买卖都是骗人的。
They were making us. They were selling and purchasing, and they tried to fool people.
他们在那所做都不将神看重。
And the things that they did was a sign that they did not consider God as important.
所以耶稣当然会很生气，要赶出去了。
So expectedly, Jesus was angry and drove them away.
所以我再次回到我们的主题，耶稣生气理所当然，那我们可以不可以生气呢？
And so Jesus can get angry, but how about us?
我记得很久以前在英文团就有讨论过，人能不能花那个易怒和 righteous anger 可以不可以产生啊？
About the possibility, or is it all right for Christians to be righteously angry?
那我想我们生气是正常的哈，不是犯罪哦。
And of course, normally we get angry, not necessarily it is a sin.
我常常会对那些痛苦的回应就是。
And when there is a suffering, sometimes we respond with anger. So we are not satisfied with the environment, we get angry.
但是我们人，因为我们人是不完全，所以我们常常带着偏见，所以我们生气的时候也是带着偏见在生气呢。
But because we are imperfect as humans, our anger sometimes is partial or
Yeah. 我们看的是只是外表。
We see only the outer appearance of a person.
我突然想到一个故事了，在电视上又是爸爸照顾两个小孩子，在心上闹，人家是受不了哈。
I remember a scene about a father who was with two children who were trying to who were very noisy and he couldn't stand this.
叫你在车上，你的反应会怎么样
？Yeah, if this is inside a public transportation, and you were there, what would be your response?
你当然会很痛苦啊。
You will, of course, feel so, feel bad about that.
我的耳朵很敏感，常常对那小声，我就哇很痛苦啊。
My ears are sensitive to noise.
那两个小孩子在那吵，你到底会对他们生气
？And those if those two kids were there, making things very noisy in their among them, what will you get? Will you be angry?
你想从表面上，你应该大大的生气，对不对
？Maybe outwardly you will show you great anger.
但是后来据说。这个爸爸是刚太太刚死掉，他没有办法来承受这个压力，带着这个两个小孩，他到底要怎么走？他一直在那里痛苦。
However, that scene, behind that, was about that father just lost his wife, and he didn't know how to, take care of these two kids, and from then on, how he will take care of them.
所以当这就是你的看法跟你的真相是完全不一样的。
And if you know, if you learned about this background, then you will, how will you respond to this situation?
你回想一下，你有没有常常在生气
？So, recall yourself. Do you get angry very often?
你要常常去控制你的情绪，不让它能够发怒哦。
So we should be able to control our emotions, not to easily be angered.
当你发怒的时候，最伤害的是谁呀？
And when you get angry, the person who you know, who is getting hurt mostly is somebody, and who is that?
当然是自己啊。
Of course, it will be yourself.
那有时候会伤到别人。
And sometimes you hurt others as well.
所以今天我们要愿神给我们智慧去勇气去面对我们的生气呢。
So today may the Lord give us wisdom to know how to face our anger.
我突然想到我们塔卡西瓦桑好像从来不生气哈。
Our Takashima sister, it seems that we don't see her getting angry.
我还没有看过她一次生气哈。
Haven't seen her get angry.
所以每个人的性情不一样，要面对的不一样啊。
So each of us have different, you know, characters, emotions.
Okay, 那我们今天的经文哈，只有两段了。第一段是21-22，谈到谋杀人的原因到底在哪里呢
？So today our verses will come from verses 21, verse 21 to 22. It talks about reasons behind possibility of murder.
那耶稣给我们答案到底怎么样去解决？23-26吗
？And Jesus gave us the answer from verses 23 to 26.
那21节这样，你们听见有吩咐古人的话，说不可杀人，又说凡杀人的，难免受审判。
We are told here. Jesus said, "You have heard what it was." That it was said to the people long ago, "Do not murder, and anyone who murders will be subject to judgment."
很清楚的，就是讲到十诫的时候，不可杀人这件事情。
This is a mention of one of the commandments of the Ten Commandments, not to commit murder.
不可杀人这件事情是。十诫对以色列百姓的教导啊。
It is a teaching towards the Israelites not to commit murder.
是从外表来约束人的一个行为。
It's a way of you know trying to suppress people from doing this kind of action.
杀人一定要偿命啊，一定要受到立法的审判啊。
Because when one commits murder, he will surely face judgment and punishment from the law.
但是有些人还会去杀人。
But still, some people commit murder.
那为什么
？Why？
那么呢，找人类历史的第一宗那个凶杀案我们在创世纪第四章1-7节
There is a historical or a biblical example to this murder.And this is from Genesis chapter 4:1-7.
我们请亚弟兄把圣经念了，《创世纪》4:1-7。
The brother will read from Genesis chapter 4:1-7.
创世纪第四章第一节，有一日，那人和他妻子夏娃同房，夏娃就怀孕，生了该隐。便说：耶和华使我得了一个男子，又生了该隐的兄弟亚伯。亚伯是牧羊的。该隐是种地的，有一日，该隐拿地里的出产为供物献给耶和华，亚伯也将他羊群中头生的和羊的自由献上。耶和华看中了亚伯和他的供物，只是看不中该隐和他的供物，该隐就大大的发怒，变了脸色。耶和华对该隐说：“你为什么发怒呢？你为什么变了脸色呢？你若行得好，岂不蒙悦纳？你若行得不好，罪就伏在门前。”他必恋慕你，你却要制服他。该隐他兄弟亚伯说话，二人站田间，该隐起来打他兄弟亚伯，把他杀了。
好，谢谢。所以这里，该隐，他就从内心动怒了，然后导致他杀了他的弟弟。
So we saw here the king.From his heart, anger was stirred, and so he proceeded to murder.
So we need to go back to our 5:22.
So going back to our main verses, Matthew 5:22.
那耶稣的答案是说， 只是我告诉你们，凡向弟兄动怒的，难免受审判；凡骂弟兄是拉家的，难免公会的审断；凡骂弟兄是魔力的，难免地狱的火。
In verse 22, Jesus taught this way, I tell you that anyone who is angry with his brother will be subject to judgment. Again, anyone who says to his brother, Lapa, is answerable to the Sanhedrin. But anyone who says, you fool, will be in danger of the fire of hell.
所以杀人是一个人心的内在的问题，是一个无缘无故在那发怒吗？
So, murder starts from the heart when there is an anger which is, anger without any specific reason.
那这里耶稣提到三方面的结果吗？
And Jesus mentions here three results of this kind of anger.
要被审断了，要被公会审判了，要有地狱火的审判。
You will be brought to judgment. Firstly, secondly, you will be tried before the court. Thirdly, you will be in danger of the fire of hell.
为什么会受到这么多的审判？因为里面的那怒气没有办法消融，就发泄出来。
And we go through this kind of judgment if there is no way for us to suppress the fire of anger in our hearts.
我突然想到我们前日本常常骂干，骂干一直在骂人啊。
When we learn Japanese, we often use the word
骂干。所以其实在这里好像说连这个都不好讲出来，就好像不好哈。
So sometimes think this is not good.
所以我们不能随便对人家生气的。
And so it's not good to be unnecessarily be angry.
也不能随便高抬自己来轻看那些别人哈。
And also not to look down on people.With our anger.
也不能常常来批评人家哦。
And also not to unnecessarily criticize people.
所以耶稣的警告是我们要处理一些人的基本的问题。
And so Jesus was teaching us to solve some basic problem of humans.
我想人的最大问题就是里面的那种罪性。
I think the greatest problem in a person is the inner, sin, the sinful nature of a person.
你好好检讨，你为什么生气？常常是里面那种罪性在那给你捣蛋啊。
You try to evaluate yourself. Why do you get angry easily? Is there something in yourself, in your nature that really gives you?
里面的那个罪性脚不好处理，会产生一些罪行出来。
So if you are not able to solve that sinful nature of yours, then it's not easy to control our anger.
我一直在想，假如很贫穷，一直三餐吃不饱，那你看到别人在说他脚没好的队友，他就会去偷，会去抢。
I was thinking for a person.Who is often, having empty stomach, hungry, and he sees people having more than they could have. Sometimes that person will think of, stealing, right, to satisfy myself.
所以有时候你好，不要对你内在的没有对付的话，会产生外面的一个行为啊。
And if you are not able to face that inner, nature, inner problems, then it will be shown on our actions.
所以怎么解决我们这个内在的问题呢？
So how do we solve our, nature, sinful nature?
那耶稣给我们答案是从23-26节。
The answer from Jesus is from verses 23-26.
也就要我们要与人和好。
Firstly, he wanted us to be in good terms with others.
所以耶稣在二三到十六提了两个例子。
And in verses 23 to 24, Jesus gave two examples.
那一个是在你的团体当中，一个是在社会当中的。
Firstly, it's about your relationship in a situation, you know, in a group or in society.
那我们来看二十二到二二十三到二十四节。
Verses 23 to 24.
Okay, 所以可以帮我们念二十二。二二三到二四，小红弟兄帮我念二三到二四，好不好？
所以你在祭坛上献礼物的时候，若想起弟兄向你还愿，就把礼物留在坛前，先去同弟兄和好，然后来献礼物。
好，谢谢。所以第一个例子是，你想，我一直在想，为什么他在献礼物时会想到别人得罪他呢？
I was thinking on this verse, how come the person who is about to give an offering to the altar, how come he remembered his brother?
应该你说在献的时候应该是向神，你直接跟神关系，你要感谢神啊，啊，谢谢你对我恩待我，你要。怎么想到另外一个弟兄的事情呢？
So, when you come before God, you're offering your thanksgiving. Think of God. How come the thought of your brother who was against you come to your mind?
我不晓得你有没有这种经验。
Have you experienced this situation?
我自己有个经验，小时候跟我的舅舅本来是很好。有时两个吵架了哈。
I remember myself when I was small, I had some quarrel with my uncle.
是没有很大事情，但是我们两个吵架，他是大我十几岁的，然后我们就吵架，然后就不理他了嘛。
And this uncle is older, more than 10 years older than I was. And when I got angry, I just didn't care about him. Mind him at all.
每天都要到 外婆外公家 去报道的人既然都不去了哈。
And every day we go to our maternal grandmother, but because of that we didn't want to go.
真的好有一阵子我是闷了生气就在家里都不去了哈。
And for many, for a long time, I was in anger, and so I just kept myself inside the house. I didn't want to see.
所以我想，他在献祭的时候想到弟兄得罪他，表示他自己也有错。
I think when that uncle would offer his would give his offering to God, he will be reminded of the other person who has been source of his anger.
所以他自己是有错误的。
So he himself is also a fault.
同样的，他们两个问题还没解决。
And the problem between the two have not been settled.
所以耶稣的劝告是很重肯的，就先去和好，再来献礼物。
So here Jesus' solution to this problem between the two was that first leave your gift.There in front of the altar, and go and be reconciled to your brother.
所以跟人和好之后，你才能够真正来敬拜神。
So it's only when you are really reconciled and in good terms with your brother that you can truly be able to worship him.
所以和好还是一个最关键的一个词。
So being in good terms with each other, good relationship with each other is a very important point.
那二十五到二十六是谈到在社会上的一个状况。
And 25 to 26 describe a situation which happens in a society.
那我们请淑莹前面帮我念二十五到二十六哈。
25 to 26 is ask Sister Su Ying to read for us.
你同胞们的对头还在路上，就赶紧与他和稀。 恐怕他把你送给审判官，审判官交给差役，就在下在你就下在监里了。我实在的告诉你，若有一分钱没有还清，你断不肯从那里出来。
好，谢谢。所以这是谈到社会上一些问题。
So it's mentioned a thing, an incident that can happen in society.
我觉得那最后一节，其实我常常给他误解哈，那我们不能跟人家随便跟人家借钱哈。
And sometimes I misinterpret verse 26, last verse. It's a reminder for us not to borrow money.
有人有一个坏习惯就是。跟人家借钱都要忘记哈，人家跟你借钱了，你都记得。
And it's very natural for humans when somebody borrowed money from another person, he can forget about the debt. But the one who lent money will always remember that.
所以，在这里其实不是钱的问题，是那没有解决一些不同意见的问题哈。
So it's not the problem of the money, but rather the solution to the two persons who have different views.
在社会上，人与人之间常常会有冲突，会很多摩擦。
In society, there will often be conflicts between people.
真的，不管什么事情，人在一起总是会有矛盾嘛。
Whenever people gather, there will always be some conflicts.
尤其在家里，只要夫妻两个哈，只要没有好好处理，也是都很多每天在吵嘛。
And even in a family between a couple, there will always be some kind of conflict.
为什么吵没有办法解决
？How come there are sometimes we cannot find a solution?
我的看见就是，你吵的时候，常常这个时候都是你的错。
Interpretation here is often when there is a conflict between two, one would say it's always because of you.
都是你让我睡不好觉。
You are the one who made me, not be able to sleep.
都是你让我吃不饱。
It was you who made me.feel hungry every time.
常常这个箭头是指向对方。
Now always point. There's always a way of pointing to the other person.
但是耶稣给你的答案不是，你要先检讨自己。
But Jesus' solution here was that first let us examine ourselves.
当你还有机会，不要被抓去关的时候，赶快想办法抢救啊！
Before you will be taken to the court, you better find ways to help yourself.
所以当你有错，赶快认错，这是最重要的。
If you were at fault, you should be the one to say sorry.
我没那事，我没那事。
Say sorry for that.
所以英语我们常常会 I'm sorry 这个放在嘴中哦，虽然当然要心要摆上，不要说 I'm sorry 这个都没有。一点都没有悔改的意思哈。
Or so we can always remember to say sorry for things that we have done. Sometimes we have to do it sincerely.
并且你要欠债了，就赶快还钱啦。
And if you are in debt, you should pay your debts.
所以这里耶稣的答案是赶快解决事情的纷争哈。
So the solution from Jesus was that let settle.The source of problems between you two.
所以在这样社会上解决问题才能够和睦同居嘛。
In that way, there will be good relationship. They can live together in harmony.
你脚不解决这纷争，那你怒气还在里面闷烧啊，那就很完蛋了哈。
It will be terrible if there is no way that you want to resolve.Conflict
in
you, because that will be
very
bad for you.
When
your anger, if you are not able to suppress or control the anger in your heart, then this is going to be it, that is to solve.
当你控制你的情绪，你还在生气的时候，也是恨的，都是一直在恨的。
And when you are not able to control the anger, sometimes it becomes, it turns to hatred. The feeling turns to hatred.
那一直恨，一直恨到最后就，好啊，我们哪天给你，
so、when the,
干掉哈。
When, the anger is, I mean, persist for a long time, sometimes it leads to a more serious thing like murder.
所以解决罪性的问题。才能解决罪行上的问题。
So, solving the problem about sinful nature is solving a lot about our problem, human problems.
Okay, 那我们是知道神对人的那宽怒哈，是一个正面的，是一个正义的哈。
We know that God is angry towards us. I mean, frankly, before us, and also it is a righteous one.
我在讲的是神对人类的那个生气都是正面的，都是正义的。
God's anger is straightforward, and it is also righteous.
那我们来看一个经文呢，在出埃及记三十四章啊，六到七节啊。
Let's look at some verses from the Bible, from Exodus.
出埃及记啊，三十四章
，Exodus 34，
六到七节啊
，6 to 7。
那我们请那个真新眼睛冒昧的三十四章六到七节
，Exodus 34 6 to 7。
耶和华在他面前宣告说：“耶和华，耶和华是有怜悯、有恩典的神，不轻易发怒，并有丰盛的慈爱和诚实。”对千万人存留慈爱，赦免罪业、过犯和罪恶，断不以有罪的为无罪，必追讨他的罪，自父及子，直到三四代。
And he passed in front of Moses, proclaiming, "The Lord, the Lord, is compassionate and gracious God, slow to anger, abounding in love and faithfulness, maintaining love to thousands."And forgiving wickedness, rebellion, and sin. Yet he does not leave the guilty unpunished, and he punishes the children and the children for the sin of the fathers to the third and fourth generation.
We know that Moses from the mountain took 2 stone tablets, came down, saw them worshiping the golden calf, he was angry, almost fell down.
We remember that Moses.With the 2 tablets from God, he came down from the mountain and he saw the sins of his people and he was so angered through the tablets.
那这里记载是第二次神要摩西再弄两块新的滑板，然后跟他见面了。
But the incident described here in Exodus 34 was the second time.God again provided 2 tablets for the people.
那在这里，神宣告他是怎么样的神呢？
And here the Lord proclaimed what kind of God he was.
这里我觉得很好的就是，万不以有罪的为无罪哈。
And here, God will never consider.Sin as not sin.
神的公义就显明，但是你一直在看神的慈爱就超过他的公义，有没有？
God is righteous, but however His compassion and His love is over and above His righteousness.
其实我们常常说啊，我才这一点点错，请你原谅我。其实哪有错，在神的面前就是要接受刑罚，要接受审判的。
Sometimes we try to argue with God, saying, "Oh, I sinned, all right, but it was just a mild sin. But it could be a great sin before God."
我们可以说，神对那个罪的容忍度是零啊。
and the Lord is our God is not able to allow sin. His endurance was zero regarding sin.
所以我以后你叫牧道友跟你讲，你看旧约的神都乱生气哈，乱杀人哈，其实不对的，是神他的公义在那里显现的。
So people might argue with you that look at the Old Testament how God gets angry, you know, killing people for his anger, but actually this is a show of God's righteousness.
是人的罪让神来审判。
It was the sin of the people that really made God make this judgment of punishment.
所以你看到人类常常违背对神的，也尤其以色列，他们三番两次来违抗神啊。
We see here that people would, you know, break their covenant with God, and even you know, rebel against God.
从此人类常常不信任神。
And then the people distrusted God.
我觉得我们不信任神对神一个很大的侮辱。
I think for us to have a distrust of God, it is a great insult to our Lord.
你可以想想自己，你有一些能力的时候，让人家来，啊、你怎么行？你一定、啊、很生气。
Some people will tell you, you know very well that you have this ability, but they try to deride you deride you that you are unable, then that will probably drive you to anger.
我们知道小薇会弹琴，她是从小弹上来的，我们连摸都不会摸。叫我说啊，小薇，你这弹的像什么？她是，
For example, your brother, Chopin, is we know that he learned piano from childhood, and suppose somebody will come to him and say.Oh, how come you play your piano that way? It's so terrible. Of course, you will be angry.
我们要知道神的发怒是带着审判的。
God's anger is a kind of judgment. It's anger with judgment.
所以你要注意，你怎么待人，神就要来同样的这样来待你。
And the way you treat others will be the way that God will treat you.
假如我生气了怎么办呢？
Suppose I got angry, then what should I do?
假如常常很喜欢生气怎么办呢？
Suppose I easily got angry, what should I do?
我刚才讲生气是很正常。也不是犯罪吗？
And of course, it's normal to be angered.
但是我们要去慢慢去控制。
But we should be able to take hold of it, control it.
有个经文很好，在以弗所四章的二六到二七哈。
There's a verse which is very good. It's in Ephesians.
庞迪姐妹帮我们找出来，好念。以弗所是第四章二六到二七哈。
以弗所书第四章二十六节，生气却不要犯罪，不要不可含怒到日落，也不可给魔鬼留地步。
Ephesians chapter 4:6-7, in your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry, and do not give the devil a foothold.
假如那个太阳都不下山怎么办呢？
Suppose the sun doesn't go down.
那你就会一直生气吗？
Can you continue to get angry?
没有，他说赶快，其实在这个意思，赶快解决，不要让你成为一个终身的遗憾。
And actually here we are being taught to solve the problem of your anger as soon as possible. Otherwise it might be a lifetime regret afterwards.
所以我就认为生气应该有两个原则，我们要自己来行的哈。
I'm sure. I think there are two principles when it comes to treating our anger.
第一个，你一定要饶恕别人。
Firstly, we must be able to forgive others. We should forgive.
甚至讲，你怎么样饶恕人，你就会被神饶恕哈。
Bible tells us that if you are able to forgive others, God will forgive you.
所以饶恕人是很好的，就是忘掉就不会再那生气了，对不对
？So forgiveness is very good for you because when you forgive, then you just forget about it.
所以当帮人家的借钱，你能够借就借嘛，你没有钱就说没有啊，我没有钱可以借你。
Somebody would come to you know borrow money from you, then you can always say I don't have something to lend you.
其实他借了没有还，因为没关系，就饶恕了，就忘记了。
And if somebody did borrow and is not able to return to you, then it's okay.
不要还惦念着，我说你看1000块借了那么久都不还来啊。
Just forget about it. Instead of you know trying to accuse the person, and oh of course you borrowed from me.You have not returned.
所以饶恕人是第一个功夫。第二个，很多事情你要让神来处理。
So firstly, forgiveness. Secondly, you should let the Lord solve the conflict.
你不要自己来伸张正义，你要来处理这件事情。
You should not put, you know, things into your hands. You should let God do His work.
不管在任何地方，学校、工作场合，你只要被虐待、被人家欺负，你让神来处理。
So whenever, wherever it might happen, in your work, in your school, if you were bullied or whatever, let God solve the problem.
只要你要去处自己去处理的话，一定会很惨很惨的。
Sometimes, if you try to solve this problem by yourself.It could end up disastrously. I also had this experience when I felt being bullied by the secretary. I wanted to take things into my hand, but I was able to control it.
所以很多事情你要认为让神来处理。
So let's remember to let God do the work.
我在军队的时候也是被人欺负了半死的。
In the army, in my army training, I also had experience of being bullied.
那让神来处理。圣经讲，深渊在我，我必报应。
So I let the Lord solve the problem, just God said.Vengeance is mine, I will
repay.
I remember in the army, when I was being bullied, God sent many angels to protect me.
我们那个副连长既然是个基督徒，常常换我架。
And in our group, the assistant.Leader was a Christian, so he would always give me some
offering.
So
那时候才能常常跟师母在约会。
I used to date with Dora.
所以让神来处理是最保险的。
So let God solve the problem. That's the most the safest way.
所以第一个你要饶恕人，第二个让神来处理。
So,Remember, firstly, forgive. Secondly, let the Lord solve the trouble.
Okay, 那我们一起来感谢。
Let's pray thanksgiving prayer.
天父，谢谢你。
Heavenly Father, thank you.
让耶稣用他的教训来勉励我们。
Jesus taught us, and encouraged us.
让我们怎样来对付我们自己的内在的罪？
Taught, teaching us how to solve our internal problem.
我们常常自以为意。
Sometimes we feel that we are righteous.
那其实我们是比别人还不好。
But sometimes it's because we are not better than others.
求你来让我们检查自己的行为的动机。
Help us, Lord, examine our motives.
到底有没有这样基督的爱拿出来？
Do we really show God's Jesus love to others?
有没有尽我们的全力来努力？
Do we work hard?
主，求你来帮助我们。
Help us.
那我们也可以，让我们的情绪也被你来掌管。
Yeah, take control of our emotions, Lord.
让你的圣灵来带领我们。
And may the Spirit lead us.
我们可以去饶恕别人。
That we can also forgive others.
主，谢谢你。
Thank you, Lord.
让我们在你里面可以成长。
That we can grow in you.
继续来教导我们。
Continue to teach us.
我们向你献上感谢。
We offer our thanksgiving to you.
继续带领我们以下的敬拜。
Continue to lead us in our worship.
我们这样感谢祷告，奉靠耶稣基督的名。
Give thanks and pray in Jesus' name.
Amen. 谢谢。